fuck. You can go into the chatting live tab on the Discord channel, and that should take you right to a conversation that we could have live. You made it. Yeah, thank you. I really, really appreciate everybody that's here today. It really means the world to me that you guys are here. So thank you so much. And I'm really hoping that we can all have a absolute blast with this game. Now, I just gotta make sure that... See? This... Sorry, I had to minimize the window. You're definitely following the wrong folio. So what I can do, Kelly, if you want, is I can send you an invite to the Discord. Where are you? Oh no, I can't. Can I? Okay, let me. Okay, so if you go in Discord on the channel's Discord, under live, there's one that says chatting live, and that one is a voice chat. So you'll be able to call me through there. There we go. Yeah, you're going to want to lower the volume or mute completely the stream itself so it doesn't echo. Now, I just want to make sure that everyone can hear Kelly. So if you could say something, and we'll get the chat to let us know if... All the bars are moving on my end, but again, let's just make sure with the chat that everything's working fine.
See if I'm using the right mic.
I can hear you, so that's a good sign.
That's good.
Okay, so Danny says that he doesn't think he can hear you. I think it's a fuck up on my end, to be honest. Let me just double check here. My apologies again. This is the first time that I'm doing this, so.
That should be good.
Yeah, I can really hear you now. And they should be able to hear you as well. Can we do another test there? Oh, you heard him now? Cool. Let's make some noise. Let's get excited. Fuck yeah. Let's throw in some...
My mic arm just like dropped right off of the support. It's so funny.
Oh, yeah?
There we go.
Okay, let me...
I had a cat like just trying to get on my lap like it was his last ditch effort for life.
Man, I was streaming earlier and my cat, one of my cats decided to fuck around. I had to kick him out and close the door. It was like getting out of
here. I'm sitting here with my girl Britt too. She's the first time she's seen it in months. First
cool.
Time she's seen the build.
Hey, Britt. So let's double check right now. Make sure that everything is sounding good. We're going to turn off the background music and we'll go back to just Sak'd. So tell me a little bit about you, Kelly. As a developer, and what kind of got you started with all of this?
I started on this stuff. Like, I've been playing video games since I was like 8 or 9, like back in Atari,
right?
So, like, an absolute addict for video games. Like, I remember being parked in front of the TV for like 2 days straight playing Ultima on the Nintendo.
Shit.
You know, stuff like that. So, you know, I dropped out of that. And stopped playing video games for a few years. You know, went out and did the standard, like, young adults, wanted to party, you know. Wanted to be a social butterfly and stuff like that. So a lot of my video gaming, you know, kind of slowed down there. But I went out and got educated on a few things. So I went to school for computer programming. systems analysis, and I hated it because it was like, you know, chasing that missing semicolon.
Right.
You know, in the end, I ended up like programming financial apps and stuff for like ACPAC, Simply Accounting, and just really dry stuff that I hated.
Right.
And what I originally got into programming for was video games. Like I was, you know, I started developing my own video games when I was 9, converting, you know, choose your own adventure books into Apple Basic programs on my parents' computer and, you know, running through them like choose your own adventures.
That's really interesting. And exactly what drove you into the choose your own adventures thing? Was that more like a D&D based thing or?
My mom, she shoveled that fantasy theme stuff down my throat from a young age. Like, I think I got my first Dungeons and Dragons book when I was 8 years old. It was like the very first monster manual for Advanced Dungeons and Dragons.
Right.
I think it was Advanced Dungeons and Dragons. And I got right into the fantasy thing, you know, reading Lord of the Rings and stuff like that, goblins, dragons, all that stuff.
Right.
And then, yeah, it was just like a natural evolution from there. I just wanted to, you know, build something around that. I got into writing role-playing games back in the day, you know, when D&D was really like popular before it was popular. Like,
right,
it's just
right.
Through the roof now.
Well, yeah, now it's crazy, man. Now it's all over the fucking place.
Yeah, and just like just destroying and just being destroyed at the same time. I'm looking at you, Wizards of the Coast, OGL.
Didn't they retracted that now though, didn't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I mean, they had to, right?
A couple of retractions, but
I mean, some of that damage is done at this point though, right?
Oh yeah, it's so done. But you know, I'm still working on that stuff, still writing my own games. I think half the world's writing their own games right now, but I still love it. Still love playing. Just got back into D&D like 5 years ago. So you know, that D&D's been a huge inspiration, like certainly on my game development side, it's always been like fantasy oriented stuff,
right?
Anything like that just is a real big turn on for me, so that's naturally where I gravitated towards with the video game thing. And with Sak'd, I mean, the character came along by accident. It evolved over years. Oh, we're missing some water.
We're missing some water. Yeah, I can see that now. Did I just...
Yeah, we're also missing monsters.
And I'm completely gone out of the map.
That's hilarious. Yeah, so can you... Are you able to even, like, before you get too deep in this, just load up that last one? Like,
this
I
is...
don't care if the Gravekeeper's a brown block at this point, but at okay. least people get a better sense of what
of
it
the,
is.
Of the game itself.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, we'll do that. I should be able to. I think I had it prepared already.
Well,
from
Andy
the last year,
he just jumped on this and like really like he's been having a lot of stuff on the go, so he just jammed on it today to try and make that build possible. So you know, like huge props to him for trying to get that out before the stream. But
yeah, no, it's all good. It's all good. It's no worries, man.
But that's the nature of the game, right?
It is what it is, bro. Like you know, we're all aware that we're playing a demo right now. We're showing a game that's still under development. So we know that the tiny little hiccups are going to happen here and there, right?
Yeah.
Just to show you guys, those that are watching, just to show you a little bit of the difference between the last build that I received and the one that I got just before the stream began. Here obviously was the graveyard keeper, and they added dialogue to this guy, so it's not just. Oh yeah, that's right. Cause the one that I played was a couple of versions ago. Not the one that I got today. I did want to point out. I wanted to point something out real quick, man. You know, one of the things that kind of really caught my attention early when I first booted this up was the attention to detail, man. And I think you guys have done a great job with keeping that throughout, at least for what I've seen of the demo, the little bit that I've seen. And the reason why I'm pointing that out now is because, if I'm not mistaken, the back end of the coins is your guys' developing team logo, correct?
Yeah, it is, yeah.
Yeah, see, like, that's fucking cool, man. And like, that might seem like very, very little, but, I mean, it would have been a lot easier for you guys to just make one coin that has the same image on both sides, right?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, this whole thing's been about, like, going the extra mile and trying to make sure that it's AAA without being AAA. Like, we wanted to make sure that we paid attention to every single part of it, so that by the time we even dumped a demo out in the public, which, you know, hopefully will should be coming up here in about a month.
Okay.
By the time that demo gets out, it's been so play tested and like just beaten to death to try and make sure that it's a smooth and fun a gameplay experience for people.
Do you have an overlay in the top left corner covering the health bar? Oh, yes, I do. Okay, thanks, Danny. I'm going to move that right away. I'm going to put this right here for now. I had put it in the corner because that's where the overlay is right now. Actually,
yeah,
I'm going to move
it
down.
Right, yeah. The corner would be a good spot for that.
Yeah, that's what I was going to do here. I'm just going to make it a little smaller, too. Welcome to our newer viewer. We're checking out Sak'd. While interviewing one of the developers. So, Kelly, you were saying where you got your inspiration for our main character here. Can you tell me a little bit of a story in regards to the character himself?
Yeah, for sure. First of all, it started with wanting to pump out something original.
Okay.
And near as I could tell, like nobody had really, up until the point at least that I started working on Sak'd, which is about 6 years ago now, nobody had ever done a pillow. and if they had, they'd had it in some kind of NPC format. Maybe there might have been a talking pillow in some other game or something.
Yeah.
I don't know why the water's not showing up.
So
why there's no monsters in here. But
yeah, because I do remember that the build that I did play, which was like two builds ago. There was water here and monsters.
Yeah.
But you know what? Like we said, it is what it is. We are playing a demo that is not quite ready to be released yet. So, exactly. Now we're all kind of witnessing to see the upgrades, right? And it kind of gives you that appreciation of how much work goes behind this. You know, like you see all the jokes on Reddit about programmers like doing, you know, you change one number and something works, but then three more things kind of go sideways.
Yeah.
This is a good example of that. Now this part right here, I'm gonna tell you right now, I know what to do because I think I got up to here and then I stopped playing because I didn't want to go too far. But I think it's freaking phenomenal the way that you guys came up with the idea of turning. As you can see, you'll turn ice when it hits the water. I really don't want to fall down and crash the game again. I think it's cool, and you know what I really do enjoy is that there's no, you're not like being screamed at on what to do. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh. Like there's nothing here telling you exactly what you need to do in order to get past this.
Yeah, the other tough part, like the challenge, I guess, with the demo level is we also wanted to make this demo level standalone. So none of this is going to be in the game. Like,
oh, okay.
Yeah, so it's its own thing. We wanted to make sure that if we were going to put something out that the general public was going to beat to death, that it wasn't going to ruin any part of the full game when they play that.
That's a really good idea.
So yeah, all the coins are gone out of here. The monsters are gone.
Okay.
Like, so I'm not sure where, at what point this thing is actually going to
load the monsters.
Mind-boggling right now because there's normally so much going on. Can you try resetting the game and clicking continue?
Let's try that.
You know what might have happened? Yeah, that's true. Like it might have loaded up your previous like walkthrough of it and just like wiped out the characters.
Right.
That you had already beaten at one point.
Right. Right. Yeah, that's right. Because there was nothing in that one, eh?
Yeah.
Okay. Let's try. Let's try with continue. And if not, maybe I can just load up the first file that you sent my way. Because that one I know had monsters up until the water, for sure.
Yeah, like the water should be there. All that stuff should be there.
Okay.
There's a little bit of irony happening here. And I love that and I appreciate that.
Okay, so I don't see monsters here, but for sure there's some up there that we didn't load up last time.
Floating eyes there. We'll see those later on anyway. But as long as from this point on, there's monsters and stuff showing up.
Oh, I guess I just died. There's a door in the area below. There's supposed to be a door on the area below. Let's go take a look. The scenes aren't loading. Shit.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, that door leads to one of the other levels down below.
Okay, so let me exit this, and I'm going to load up the first one that you sent me. My apologies to my viewers. Like I said, we're kind of doing this as we go, so we're trying to figure it all out. I wonder if the fact that I have all these versions still loaded in my computer might be affecting this.
That might be. Like, I've had that happen before, too, where it was basically loading up save states where creatures had already been killed.
The game does look really nice, man. Okay, so what would you recommend me to do? Would you prefer me to... Okay, let's do this. Let me check out the first version you guys sent me.
Sure.
And if that one also isn't showing enemies or anything like that, then we know that it's a save thing, because I know for sure the other one had enemies all the way up to the water area. So
at least it's a quick load.
Yeah, that's the thing. That's the other thing too that I noticed. It doesn't take long to get going, which is great. You know, especially nowadays, everything seems to be going in that direction of. Okay, so those enemies are there. I dropped below and they disappear the first time, so we'll try that now. Oh shit. Okay, well there's people now.
Oh yeah.
Okay. Yeah, wow. This just got a lot harder.
So, yeah, there you go. So I was curious, did you catch the skull in the background in this area?
I just did. Literally, as you were saying it, I just caught it.
So we tried to drop like little subtle stuff like that, like all through the game, right?
Right. You guys have definitely done a really good job with this. I am quite impressed. I didn't expect any less from you though, because of when we were playing D&D. We just watching you draw. Can you go to the door below? Okay, let's go do that.
So down, if you drop back down and go over to the right, there's another door. Like back down where those eyes were.
Back here?
And then further over to the right. And down below.
Oh, there we go. Wow, there's so much stuff.
So that door there.
Oh, that's cool. See, like I didn't see any of this. So you said you drew some inspiration out of D&D and whatnot, which is it's pretty evident, especially with the goblins.
Yeah.
Where else would you say that you drew inspiration from?
Wonder Boy in Monsterland.
What's that? Sorry.
Wonder Boy in Monsterland. So it's like an old arcade game. Came out for Sega Master System too.
Oh, cool.
And it was all like colorful and cartoony, and I absolutely loved it. And so this particular iteration, even the original like 2.5D iteration of Sak'd was, you know, loosely based on that as well. And Rayman. Rayman's like one of my all-time favorite, like basic, really super basic, but cartoony fun games where you just like kind of plow through stuff.
Yeah.
And yeah, it was just kind of that game rhythm and the cartoony aspect of it that
kind of drew you.
Create something along that same line.
That makes sense. I can see that. I can see the influence for sure in Rayman. The chat's asking, what's the purpose of the coins?
So right now, the only purpose of the coins is achievements, at least for the demo purpose. But there are shops in the full game, so you'll be able to upgrade your weapons, buy potions, do a lot more RPG stuff.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, and if you go on the website too, like sak.ca, there's the Sak'd game link that's under that. I think Jose's posted that a couple of times in here too.
Yeah,
you'll see that there's like character sheets, there's like character options and stuff like that. So it's a fully fledged RPG.
Oh, that's cool, man. That's
yeah,
definitely
so it's
cool.
Not just like right here, it's fairly run through, you know, smash and grab, slay some monsters and stuff. But we wanted to make sure that, you know, people had the ability to change up their character, to improve their weapons, their armor, you know, pick up items and have like meaningful side quests and dialogue with NPCs.
So again, that sounds to me like you're sitting down there and playing D&D with me.
Yeah, right.
And I absolutely love that, man. Yeah, you guys had a big influence in how much I like D&D today.
That's awesome, man. I love to hear that.
Yeah, we played last Friday, and I made a bit of a mistake as a DM, and the shit got real, man.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, oh yeah, shit got real. It was a stupid mistake on my behalf, though, I'll give you that.
You know, I think that is probably half the fun of D&D right there, is all the mistakes you make as a player and a DM.
Like, yeah.
I started running games too about 3 years ago, and it's like really the first time I've been DMing in a long time. Like, we're talking 20 years. And getting back into it and trying to adapt to 5e and the new rules systems and stuff like that, and the whole time, like, I'm doing it because I'm old school 2e. So I'm just like, I'm hearing rules and things like that where I'm just like, oh, that's such garbage. right away, I start falling back on my, you know, homebrew stuff. But, you know, the amount of mistakes I made as a DM over the last 3 years, some of them have just been so fun and have added to the hilarity and the excitement of
the game. Yeah, yeah, I can see that. And like, some of the mistakes that I've made as a DM have had that same result, actually. Yeah. Except that last week I ended up killing a character, so that didn't go well. Yeah, no, it was stupid too, but this is really cool. So not right now, again, I'm gonna go ahead and point out, to me, it's awesome how you have used your, you've added all your magic to mean something. You know, I find that a lot of games end up having magic and it's just there. You know what I mean? You can attack people, you can attack the enemies with them, but that's the extent of it. I really enjoy how you've used the magics as part of the puzzles to solve.
Yeah, we definitely wanted to take it a little bit further than just like, you know, smashing enemies. And like things like the ice magic and stuff, those will do your standard freeze enemies and stuff in the full game, but we wanted to make sure that all the puzzles incorporated some elements of, you know, the elemental magic.
Yeah, for sure. And that decision to make it like an elemental magic thing, is that based on anything or you just thought it'd be better than, you know, like your usual?
Again, it's like D&D. I just really love the elements and the elemental magic in Dungeons and Dragons. The idea of, like, you know, different planes, you know, going to these different worlds that are really like oriented to fire and oriented to water, and all the creatures that you might encounter in each of those environments.
Right. That's cool. That's really cool. Are you gonna be able to? You said you'd be able to purchase different magic or anything like that throughout the game. Are you gonna start with all of these, or is this something that you're gonna be unlocking as you go?
Yeah, you'll be unlocking them as you go. We wanted to give everybody a taste of each of the magics in the demo, but you'll have to unlock them through different quests. You know, some of them you might have to, you know, find, unlock certain spell scrolls and stuff, but
cool.
It's a lot like the weapons and the armor and stuff. You'll find it in chests, you'll find it through defeating monsters or completing side quests.
Okay, and now, what was my next question in regards to magic? So if I'm understanding this correctly, you guys basically made this demo differently from the game with the intention of kind of showing us what the game is capable of without giving away any sort of story behind it.
Gotcha. Yeah, exactly. Although the demo will incorporate, it's like the
it's like a prequel. Prologue. Yeah, prologue. Yeah, that's the word I was looking for.
Prologue to the full game. So there'll definitely be some dialogue and some story elements in this demo when it's completed.
Yeah.
Kind of, you know, get the character going. It'll give players an idea of how Sak came to arrive here, what he's here to do, and you know, kind of lead him into the full game. So hopefully, by the time everybody's done playing the demo, they'll be really eager to
get
Sak's adventure.
Well, I'm already intrigued, man, I haven't gotten that, you know, the full demo yet. But even with what I've played so far, It looks like a lot of fun, man. And I am having a lot of fun playing it. And this isn't even my kind of game, eh? Like, this isn't the kind of game that I would normally play.
Yeah.
But this is this is a blast. I've been
catching up on watching a few of those Call of Duty.
Yeah. Yeah, that's where I decide to embarrass myself.
See, we got little ghosts there. So that little ghost that's wandering around I should make a call out. So another fellow developer developed Little Ghost. You can go on Sak'd and look up, or go on Steam and looked up Little Ghost. And he was kind enough to insert a little image of Sak'd in his game.
Okay.
You have to search through his whole game to try and find where Sak'd is in his game. But he's such a kind developer and working really hard as just a solo dev. He's got no team with him. He has somebody that helps him out occasionally on, you know, some of the art stuff, I believe. But, yeah, he worked really hard producing that game, and he actually was successful at Kickstarter, so he's working on the full version of his game.
That's awesome.
And so we decided to drop Little Ghost in here for a cameo, and he'll help Sak'd out with some dialogue.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
So one
of the things that Little Ghost is going to help players understand is that with Earth magic, you actually have to be grounded to use it.
just like I was trying to jump up there and try to use it, and it wouldn't work. So now the ground magic, and maybe I'm reading a little bit farther into this, but is the ground magic requires you to be on the ground because it is based on ground magic?
Yeah, because it's pulling from the earth, right?
That's cool. That's really neat, man. I like, again, and I'm going to repeat this. The amount of attention to detail that you guys have put into this, it's incredible. It's absolutely incredible.
Thank you so much, man. Like, it really, it's nice to have somebody notice that. They put a lot of effort into this.
Well, and I mean, like, I've been, in a way, promoting this game to my friends for years now, too. Like, ever since you gave me, like, the hat that I'm wearing right now and the pins and stuff, almost every time that I play D&D with a bunch of new people, I usually... like, you hand them out a pin or a hat or something that I can, right?
It's awesome, yeah.
But it's incredible, man. And like, even my son's half-brother, he still remembers. Like, I was telling him about it, and he was like, oh, yeah, Sak'd, I remember. And he still has a pin and everything in his room now, you know?
That's so awesome. Yeah, I really appreciate that, man.
Well, this is great. This is fun.
Like a small developer, I think the biggest challenge is actually marketing yourself and
getting
that word out.
Of course.
You know, especially on a project like this where it's going to take a few years.
It will, yeah, yeah. No.
We're far enough along in the development that when as soon as we get funded, we should be able to crank out the full game, we're hoping, in about a year.
Yeah. Oh, that's awesome, man. That's great.
Yeah.
Now, I'm a little stuck here.
So yeah, this one's a real challenge. So the idea is to jump up and try and grab that ledge on the right and then bounce over to the left.
Oh shit, gotcha.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't think I was gonna make it.
Yeah.
Okay, here we go. Okay, we gotta celebrate this shit. Put some soundboard in there, man. Somebody add some shit in the background. Okay, we got this. Now, we've done a full circle. Did I go the wrong way?
So now you go back up.
Okay, gotcha. Yeah.
So now that you've gone through and activated that that air marker, that air elemental air marker, so now you can travel up and over.
I don't think I did. Oh, there it is. This thing.
No, actually, you didn't activate it down there.
Now, how do I do this?
Use the air magic. So the one you've been slinging is the water magic. So
okay.
The green one on your elemental spell marker.
Oh, gotcha. Okay.
Yeah, that's the air. Yeah, so now if you try and go up, you'll see that there's platforms floating and stuff.
Yeah, I see that. That's really cool, man. Wow, so this is a full new area, right?
Yeah.
Or this is where I came from.
No, you go back to the right there.
See? Oh, that makes sense. That's awesome, man. This is great. Oh, shit.
So you haven't been this far before?
No. The farthest I got was with the water. Where I had to freeze the...
Wow, this is awesome, man.
Yeah, oh yeah, man. No, and I wanted to save it because I wanted to get, like, more of a... organic reaction on the stream. Yeah. So I really wanted to save it. And like I said, when we played D&D and I would watch you draw, whenever our DM was calculating stuff. I did pay a lot of attention to how detailed you were in all your drawings, so I genuinely didn't have any concerns that this was not gonna be, you know, well enough for the stream.
Yeah,
so I didn't want to.
The artwork's been a big thing. I owe the majority of the art style and everything on this to our Alejandro, aka Grenius, and Expedo also for programming, for art, Rich. These guys are amazing, and they've really helped to translate what's going on, the mess in my head and what you're seeing now.
Well, they've done a great job. I see Andy there says, I appreciate your attention to detail. Yeah, it's kind of hard not to. Is there anything behind this? As we talk about details behind
there,
the statue?
You see the statue here, Lemus?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the guy on our team that's responsible for all the awesome animation you see.
No way. So basically we ended up having a discussion in the animation and everything just as we were approaching his statue.
Yeah, so Lemus usually takes concepts from Grenius and from Rich and then he animates the living shit out of them and makes them look all beautiful like that.
That's cool.
And incidentally, those statues, for anybody backing us on Kickstarter, we're gonna put a statue of you like that in this game.
That's the other thing I wanted to touch on. So there's going to be a Kickstarter for sure, right? When is that releasing and what kind of packages?
In March.
Okay,
so that's coming right up. We're gonna give some people early access. We're probably gonna give some people following your stream some early access to the demo when it's ready.
Cool.
And we're gonna of course release that to the media and stuff like that to give them some early access and some opportunity to chat about it before the Kickstarter. And then, we got some really good rewards in our Kickstarter, too, where you can contribute to, the development of a new boss, which is some of the monsters. We can, include a statue of you in the game. Get immortalized in Sak'd and see about swinging down to Kickstarter to back our team on getting this full game out.
Yeah, no, that would be awesome. And that's exactly what I wanted to touch on, what kind of packages were you planning, and you explained that very well there. I mean, it'd be awesome to have a statue in this. Do you guys have any plans going forward with this? Are you still just focusing on one step at a time?
Well, we've got the whole game kind of planned out. From that standpoint, that's why I say development should probably only take us about a year. Once we've got the core elements of development down to our liking, and it's getting there. The demo's been a huge boon for that, where we've been able to test out so many things that we wanted to attempt in the full game right here in the demo.
Right.
So we've worked out a lot of bugs and a lot of things that we probably would have run into in later development.
Right.
So hopefully that'll accelerate some things. Another thing that we did is I should make mention too that on the sak.ca website, we've got a full layout of the upcoming Kickstarter campaign.
Okay.
Locked up there.
Perfect.
So if anybody wants to go and check that out and see and offer us critiques, if you see some ways that we can improve that Kickstarter campaign, drop into that site, have a look over what we're going to lay out, and let us know. We've pretty much put it out in the public eye already so that people can offer us some good feedback on where we could improve.
Yeah, that sounds legit to me, man. Andy, could I get you to post the Kickstarter link? Yeah, you could probably do that as well. I'm not doing very good with this, trying not to get hurt by these monsters. These guys are picking my ass.
So the actual Kickstarter is here. And we can use all the followers and all the publicity on that we can get. So, anybody, tell 10 friends. We'd seriously love you and appreciate you for doing that. And then for the Kickstarter mock-up, we've put that.
It looks like my one bot was trying to prevent that from happening. Could I just double check with the chat if the link is, if you can see the link? I just want to make sure that it's there.
So if not, I'm posting it in Discord too.
Yeah, we can do that as well. We'll do that. Now, as far as enemies, as far as enemies, I imagine a lot of inspiration came from D&D as well.
So there we had to tread a fine line on like inspiration versus plagiarism. So,
yeah.
You know, we didn't want to piss off the, you know, litigious folks over at WOTC. So, you know, we tried to stick to classical fantasy and mythology.
Right.
You know, we dropped a few notables in there that you might see hints of, you know, reminiscent of D&D creatures maybe, but
not necessarily like a copy of it.
Yeah, exactly. So we tried to keep those to a minimum. But yeah, I mean, inspiration is pretty much drawn from my huge love of fantasy and monsters.
I love them, man. I like how I do really enjoy how they all seem to have their own personality in a way, you know what I mean? Like, sometimes you do come across these games where like all the enemies just kind of behave the exact same.
Yeah.
And I do like that these ones are not like that.
Yeah, you know, actually I really appreciate you bringing that up too, because so you were going the right way there, Jose.
Originally?
Yep. So you just gotta drop down and then climb the wall up to the right. That one spike pit where you were unable to jump over.
Yeah.
So there's a little trick to that too.
Oh shit. The hell did I see? Oh, I'm on the other side now. I gotta go activate that checkpoint here so I don't end up. There we go. That's the other thing I wanted to point out that I do kind of enjoy. And like I wanna say I'm your average side scroller adventure player. But I do like the fact that your checkpoints are not, you know, you hit the last one and anything that happens, that's the one that you go to. You know what I mean? I like that I could have used that other one. Motherfucker. Fuck. Okay, I'm fucking not doing this at all.
So when you're up on that second block, just jump straight up.
There we go.
Hop on top of it.
Okay, we'll get this. Okay.
So
I fucking missed it.
Yeah, you'll want to hit that marker too.
Oh yeah. Fuck off. At least there, you know, it's showing that it's not like you just walk
three,
in and fuck it.
Three.
Yeah, yeah. Just like that.
There you go.
Now this looks breakable.
There you go. So you want to go up here first.
Up here?
A little fire, a little electricity, a little earth.
A little of everything. Okay.
Yeah, so you'll have to go back and burn that wood back there.
Okay.
And then once you burn the wood, then you'll be able to get up and fire some electricity at the marker to unlock the next part.
There we go.
Of course, we make you launch that fireball standing right over the spikes, right?
Well, that adds to the game too, though. You know what I mean? Like, it's it makes you think, and that's what I'm really enjoying about this game so far, is that nothing is, like, it's pretty straightforward in certain areas, but I find that the there are some things that really do make you stop for a second and go, okay, now what do I have in my possession as far as magic? What is my character capable of doing before you continue? And I'm really enjoying that, to be honest.
And just imagine this part before we added the shield.
Oh yeah. Yeah, because the shield is new, right?
Yeah. I mean, it's meant to be. It was meant to be there the whole time, but we've been working on so much other stuff that.
Now, when you have the full demo out, will there be? You said there's gonna be more dialogue and more. Are you gonna have some sort of like a movie to introduce?
Yeah,
cool. That's awesome. I'm really looking forward to that.
So I mean, the game originally started as a 2.5D huge RPG adventure, and we've dropped a couple of videos out there that kind of show like the how that game was designed. And we switched courses here. Like when the pandemic hit, we lost a lot of volunteer help that we had.
Oh yeah.
And we basically had to like say, well, we either give up this project for a couple of years while this pandemic deals with itself, or we work on another game that's smaller, easier to produce, and that's where we ended up with this one. So the other game starts out, like the 2.5D game starts out with, you know, this tower collapsing and Sak'd getting thrown from it and landing in the middle of the woods, and it starts to rain and he crawls into this hole in the bottom of a tree and basically sleeps off the night, and it wakes up the next morning and Sak'd starts his adventure, and that's where game starts. So when he crawls into that log, this game is the dream that Sak'd has.
Oh, that's fucking neat, man. So this is the dream he's having while he's sleeping right now. That's your demo.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. I like that. Now, is this going to be what you would think a save point? Or is this just decoration?
No, that's just decoration.
Okay. I'm overthinking it now. See, that's how much attention to detail you guys have put into this game that now everything I look at, I'm like, what kind of second meaning does this have? The book had a dialogue in the newer version. Gotcha.
Yeah, so we dropped little game hints and stuff all through this. This demo is meant to act as a bit of a tutorial for the full game.
And that's great, man. I do really like it when games do that. Because now, you know, if you've played it, you could probably skip a tutorial, right? You could also add this to your game. Not telling you what to do, but like you could add this to your game for those that didn't play it, and you could call it a tutorial.
Yeah, exactly. You know, for sure, man.
Fuck off. I'm like trying not to get mad. It had a little bit of tip. It had a little tip to charge the lightning spell.
Yeah, with the book.
Oh, okay. Oh, so it would tell you how to do precisely like this.
Charge up the lightning.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you're going the right way there.
Oh, I had the right idea.
So there's a little trick to that. Yeah.
Too soon.
Figure this
out. Oh, okay. Okay. There we go. Look at that. Fuck me. This I'm gonna steal.
Just
I'm gonna cheat.
Mobbed in there.
Yeah, man. I'm gonna cheat a little. So now, am I hearing his heartbeat?
Yeah, you would be. Yeah.
So that's his indication of. It sure beats the Legend of Zelda little ding 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 ding. That's cool. I really like the heartbeat because it does kind of give you that extra, like that sense of urgency. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
That like I better be fucking careful. Now, I'm going to ask you this, and if I'm wrong, I hope it doesn't come across as criticism. Now, if when I'm playing the game, I'm gonna have a certain amount of lives. Right now, it's unlimited because of it's a demo.
Yeah. That's
okay.
Right.
Okay.
And the deaths are actually, like, right now there's no death animation, but the deaths in the full game is really going to be one of the highlight features. We've, like, crafted up, you know, 50 ways for Sak'd to die in all kinds of crazy ways.
Are they going to be, like, on the violent side? As in,
yeah.
Like, are we going to see
sure.
him get cut in half?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's awesome. I'm going to tell you right now, man, I'm really enjoying this. I think you guys have done a great job with this game so far.
Thank you so much. Yeah, honestly, yeah, like Andy's been legendary like for the last like year and a half now. He's he's really just been like pounding away at this thing, trying to, you know, fine tune it from the development side.
Right.
You know, he's been the hardcore programmer. Xbeto's been in there as well, working hard on the dev side. So it's been a huge undertaking, like huge.
Yeah, I can just imagine. Oh, I could have jumped up here. Chat's asking, what kind of anatomy does Sak'd have? Will there be blood or feathers when he dies?
So that's going to be optional. So you'll be able to choose whether you want blood or feathers.
Keeping it PG
So it'll be PG or full adult, and the full adult, like, you'll see bones and guts and everything.
That's cool. I can't say this enough. You guys have put in a lot of work with the details here, man. It's like, even this puzzle right here, awesome. But just the fact that you'd have the two death animations, one that is, you know, more PG than the other one, that's great, because like a lot of games will do one and or nothing, you know what I mean? It's either you get blood or you get nothing. There is no in between.
There's a couple of things that we wanted to make sure and get in here, and one was like that this was gonna be cool to play for kids.
Yeah,
like,
no,
kids will see this character and they'll want to play it, and sometimes, you know, the blood and stuff is too violent, so
yeah,
we have an option to turn the blood to slime, to change the color of the blood to different colors and stuff.
Cool.
So.
Cool. Oh, now we're looking at is this the one that the Jesus? Okay, so now we get to here on the newer one is the one that I should be able to fight this boss, correct?
No, so we're still working on the AI for the Gasha Dokuro. That's that big skeleton boss. Right now we're just tweaking the dialogue and stuff, but yeah, Andy's working hard on the AI side of things for that boss right now.
Wow, man. This has been great. This was great, man. I let's see what the chat says. What do you guys think? Not gonna lie, I'm not usually into the genre of game, but it looks something even I would enjoy it. Yeah, man, it and that's exactly what I was saying too. Like, this isn't my kind of game either, but I got glued, and I mean like literally glued into this.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Man, you guys have done a great job.
Yeah,
you guys have done a great
playing.
Job
thank
so
you
far,
so
man.
Much
no,
for, like,
no, 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 no. Of course, man.
There.
Of course, of course. No, I'll help you guys out as much as I can. With whatever I can. I'm gonna play it again one more time for those that are gonna join in a little bit late, but I do want to know if the chat has any questions that they would like to ask the developers while you guys are here. There was another secret door?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, so that means we're gonna have to do this again, and we can continue to chat through it. I mean, we gives us an opportunity to kind of see things that we may have missed the first time. Like I said,
try with minimal sound effects in there, like sound effects and music.
Turn it down?
No, like bring it up a bit. Like I thought you were running it like on mute.
Oh. Okay, gotcha. Let's turn it up a bit. Yeah,
oh,
you're right.
I guess it's because I've got it muted because I'm in the chat too, right?
Yeah, no, and I did have it on the lower side as far as volume. Now, I see that I have two wheels, right? What is this wheel for?
Oh, that wheel's gonna be for items.
Okay, and that's still in work in progress, right?
Yeah, it's on a to-do list for sure.
Okay. Yeah, no, I was wondering that because I remember seeing it the first time that I played and I wasn't sure. Now this game is gonna be available for computer for sure. What other consoles would you be able to find this?
So we have to release it on one platform before Nintendo will even patch us with the kit. So we have, they said no. So we're gonna release on Steam first, and then and coincidentally, like, this build actually seems to run relatively good on Mac already.
Okay.
I didn't build it for Mac, but it just it's Andy's done such an amazing job in X-Beto 2 on the development side of things that, like from a coding aspect, it's just, it runs really well. So, but we're planning on releasing it for Mac and for Linux. I got a friend who's going to port it out for Linux.
Wow.
For the small audience that's there.
I was going to say. And, I hope it's not going to be a lot of work.
Great for PlayStation and Xbox.
Yeah, that will be your first goal.
Yeah, and then once we've released it on Steam, honestly, Nintendo Switch is the platform I think this game would probably do the best at.
That's exactly what I was thinking too, and that's kind of why I was asking you if you're gonna be aiming for.
Yeah, once we get it released on Steam and we've got, you know, even a modicum of success with it there, then we're going right back to Nintendo and saying, "What's up?"
Yeah, literally, what up? Check us out.
Let's get this on Switch. I'm due to be going to Japan in spring of next year.
Okay.
And as it happens, the guy that's porting this out on Linux for us is going to help us with that. He lives about a 20-minute walk from Sega and Nintendo headquarters.
Oh, wow.
So if I got to drop a demo disc right on, you know, Nintendo's front
doorstep,
desk,
yeah. That's cool, man. Because, like you said, as soon as the question kind of got brought up, the first system that came to mind was for sure the Switch. Yeah. Oh, this would be perfect for Switch, man. And I'm telling you right now, Ben would eat this game up in a heartbeat.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah, man. I can guarantee you he would. And same with Trey. Like, the minute that that this has, like, any sort of, especially any hints to D&D, Trey's going to eat it up, too. This is great, man. So we got a question here. Is there going to be a level creator or something of that sort?
No, there won't be in the initial game. I mean, that might be something we can add afterwards. But, you know, really the biggest problem is there's so many features that we want to pump into the full game. But, you know, we'll see what happens on Kickstarter. If we get enough support on Kickstarter and we get enough extra scraps there to be working with, like, the whole point of the Kickstarter is to drive as much development possibility and potential into the full game as we can.
Right.
A lot of features we'd like to add, you know, procedural generation of dungeons was one of them. So that every time that you play a level, essentially that level will be different every time.
Right. Yeah, that would be cool.
You know, we thought about doing that too, but everything costs time, everything costs, you know, money.
Yeah.
And in the end, you know, we've got a really rocking game. We think as it stands, so everything else is just going to be bonus.
Yeah, for sure. And that's definitely a good thing to bring up is the game as it is just a lot of fun already, man. Like, I don't remember the last time where I felt the need to play a demo a second time. I think it was Beautiful Joe for the GameCube.
Okay, yeah.
I think that was the last time I ever played a demo that I was like, you know what, I'm gonna play this again. And I'm not just doing this because we're live. Like, I legitimately enjoy this enough to want to do it a second time. Again, and if this is gonna sound super repetitive because I've said it like 4 or 5 times, but you guys have done an amazing job with this fucking game.
Thank you so much.
Okay, we'll do this. Andy, you gotta let me know where is the
So that's the first one. The other one's up in the like mausoleum castle type area. There's okay. Another door right near a set of spikes that'll have an exclamation mark over it.
Okay, so when we get near it, you gotta let me know in case I miss it again.
Yeah, for sure.
A little after the first one. So how many people you had on your development team again? If you were to count them up?
Right now there's about, in total there's 10 of us that have been working on it fairly steady. I would say the number's closer to 14 if we're talking like everybody that's really, you know, put some effort and helped out in making this game what it is.
Right.
You know, right now there's about, you know, 4 or 5 of us chugging away on this at various points. But yeah, it's a hard thing to keep up with. Like, we've all got regular jobs and stuff like that. And, you know,
yeah.
It's such a passion that we're all, you know, fighting time late nights and working different hours and stuff to just try and move it forward every week.
Can you lower the game volume a touch?
Yeah, I can do that.
Oh, I see it now. It's getting fucking loud. and you guys are all from like different areas of the world, so, let's say.
Yeah, so we've got Andy's from Brazil, Grenius, Lemus, Rosa, Erica, they're all in Mexico. And of course there's myself and Roland here in Alberta. We've had people like from all over help us at one point or another. Like it's really even like just hard to fathom the amount of like volunteer help that really got this project off to the start that it was. We had 26 volunteers probably working on, seven different countries, eight different countries at one point when this first started. And then This game really has been the efforts of about eight of us.
And what drew all of you guys in together? Because I mean, for you to get somebody from Brazil and Mexico, there must have been some sort of conversation happening beforehand.
Yeah, so like we met and connected through friends of friends and like in various ways. And some people that came on just saw the project and actually wanted to help, and they, started volunteering where they could. And then, as we were able to gain like some bits and pieces of funding from private investment here and there, we've been able to make, some people a little more, I guess, not really full time, but, definitely start contributing to them so that they could start spending more time on it rather than, just the occasional. So that's the door down there.
Right here. Gotcha.
Yeah.
Oh, cool. What was I going to say? So you guys just kind of came across each other and you had a bit of a similarity in the passion for this game.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, and like we've definitely like reached out to various individuals. Like we were connected. Some people met through like Grenius teaches animation in Mexico. He's an instructor down there, and for like all kinds of reasons you can see.
Yeah.
His art is phenomenal.
It is for sure.
And got connected through friends of friends and different ways like that, and just kind of brought it together. We've all been like bashing away at this thing for a few years now. We got a nice Aztec jungle theme going on here.
Yeah, no, this is cool, man.
Hey,
I got the coins, I man. Did yeah no Andy hooked me up there. But I'm not a big fan of games that kind of like hold your hand too much. Or those that completely leave you aside. And I personally really do enjoy, again, the detail of, like, I only knew that there must have been something up here because that coin fell right where Sak is right now and it kind of bounced its way out. I ignored it because I wasn't sure if that was like an actual step or not, but that your average gamer will see that and will know, like, I gotta go up there without you guys having to scream at it like there's something up here for you guys to look at. Like right here again. See? Like, so now you've done it once and you kinda keep an eye for it. So again, there's no hand holding and it's exciting shit to like, come across. Especially if you like you said, if you're gonna end up being able to buy items and stuff with these coins later on when the game gets going.
Yeah.
All those little chests are gonna be so handy, right?
Okay, for sure. Yeah, like Andy was saying right now, he's like, he mentioned that the full game will be full of those secrets, and there will be. Like, if you think, you can run the game and run it start to finish and end up missing, 90% of the game.
Because right.
There's so much that's gonna be contained in side quests and secrets.
That's cool. So basically, it's gonna give you guys a chance to have, like, this game running for a long time, which I mean a lot of people, especially nowadays, with all the issues that we're having with big developers releasing like half-assed games that are mainly focused on multiplayer, you guys are gonna be able to cater to the crowd that would rather have the single player game. And especially when the game will be full of little secrets, that's gonna make you wanna come back.
Yeah. Yeah, we're hoping for some replayability on it too. Like when you finish the game, I mean, you're gonna find that, you know, oh, I only got 70%.
Yeah. No, and you guys are, like I said, it's great because I don't this isn't my solid game, man. And like if you go through my history of the games that I've streamed and whatnot, fuck off. But I am absolutely loving this. I really am. You can light up those background candles with the torch. Yeah, oh, okay, cool. Which ones? The ones that I just walked by, or?
Yeah, I think those ones, the ones like
oh, back here.
See, that's not lit can probably be lit.
Oh, cool.
Like those ones there.
This is where I got stuck last time, isn't it?
Yeah. Just smashed.
Oh, like that one right there. Cool.
Yeah, we made it too. Like sometimes you'll think the answer is to just like, yeah, some of those candles will reveal secrets like in the full game.
Right.
You know, or they'll unlock stuff. But we wanted to also make it too, like some of these challenges, you think the idea is to like jump crazily or like move fast through this or that. And sometimes it's just a simple jump straight up and land on something.
Yeah.
You know, while it moves.
Well, again, like that's kind of what makes this game so much fun is that you have to think a lot, and it's not just straightforward move that way or this way, you know, like there's lots of little secrets and little things here. This is a blast, man. This is a blast, an absolute blast.
I'm really glad you're having a good experience with it for sure.
And it does really look like it's not just me, man. Like my one of my viewers here was saying that he's not big into these games, but he might even check it out because
yeah, you can know, crouch. That's probably like one of the hugest props going right there.
Yeah.
It's like for people that don't play this type of game to even have an inkling to try it out. That's huge for me. That's the kind of stuff fills my heart.
Yeah, like, for sure. Okay, so you can crouch to dodge the skeleton swords attack. Okay, and that's the big skeletons, right? The only skeletons, right? These guys. Okay, let's see it. Oh, I went fucking face the wrong way. See, and that like that's another aspect that I find really interesting is that it's something that it's not just because of like against the skeleton, but like it's another way of defending yourself. It's not just I'm gonna put up my shield and then I'm gonna attack. You know what I mean? It does change things up a little bit.
Yeah, the air spell works as an air shield too.
That's what I was thinking. Just oh fuck this guy. This guy always fucks me up. That's what I figured based on some of the stuff that I saw. I almost jumped into that thing that keeps crushing me. But yeah, no, like I said, I can't believe how good this is, man. I'm very, very pleased with it. And I'm excited to see the full game.
You know, the other challenge, too, is like not being a perfectionist when you're trying to knock a demo out. Like, there's so many things that we want to just show people and many things we want them to do. But, you know, we gotta wait to launch that Kickstarter.
Yeah. You can't give away all your eggs, right? Thank you, Andy. I really appreciate the follow. It is great to have you here today. Yeah, you can't be showing everything at once, man, because you gotta leave us wanting more, right? And you've done that already with me personally, with what you have here. I can't wait, man. I'm so excited. And I mean I was excited before. With all due respect, the biggest reason why I was excited before was to support you as an individual. And I say with all due respect, because I don't want it to come across like I didn't care about your project, and it was more of a you thing. But my main source of excitement in regards to this game was because I wanted to see you succeed.
Much love, I appreciate that.
You've completely kind of fucked yourself here now, because now there's more to it. You know what I mean? Like, it's not just you now. Now yeah. I want this game because it just looks like it's because it's the fucking blast, man. Like this is great. I can't wait. I can't wait, man.
Man, the slimes, Andy. The slimes added so much here.
Yeah, no kidding. And it's such a, you know, you look at these things, and like, what would you say, like, low key.
Yeah.
Would think like it's not even a big deal, you know, like it's they're minimal and they're just like a nuisance, but.
Wait till you see them in the full game. They can actually like drop down or slodge like side to side across from wall to wall.
Fuck, that's cool. I like that. I like that. I like that it adds that extra element.
And of course, we got the different slimes. We got the red slime, the blue slime. They all have different properties. And of course, for anybody that's played the old school Dragon Warrior, we definitely included a metal slime.
You can crack. Okay, we're still on that same. Welcome to our new viewers. We are reaching a personal record today, man. We did this last time. Look at that. Killed it by accident. This is great, man. Again, I'm gonna point out how much I do enjoy the fact that you use the magic to solve puzzles, and it isn't just used for attacking enemies. Is there going to be like exclusive world space on different areas, I guess? Because I mean, you showed in the demo that you have your like a desert world and what you'd be like an Aztec jungle theme. There's going to be plenty of those.
Yeah, so there's 15 different levels, and then there's, you know, we've got like two bonus levels in there as well, and each one has its own unique environment, its own unique challenges.
And will the enemies change based on levels, or will they remain kind of your average, see here?
Each environment has a whole bestiary of baddies to go with it.
That's cool.
Yeah, that's probably like one of the main focuses of this game was to cram it full of as many monsters as we possibly could, give it a nice variety. So I think in total there's about 120 monsters going into it.
120, man, that's crazy. And yeah. your game's website, Sak'd.ca, you can find a lot of this information. There's background in there as far as where Sak'd came from and everything, correct?
Yeah, cool. There's a whole history that talks about like the difference between this game and the other Sak'd, the 2.5D game. And like you can catch the blog on there too. There's, you know, we talk about the background of like the differences between the two and where they came from and why we decided to get into this one. I know we touched on that a bit earlier in the dream, but...
No, it's... I'm fucked. at least it's something that people can go and take a look at after. Now... If I hit this guy with the rock, it's not really doing anything. Is that because of his shield?
It is doing something. It's just like you gotta hit it. Certain magic will have more effect. Like fire spells will do more to certain undead than, you know, earth spells.
Earth spells. Gotcha. Now, as far as music and stuff, where do you base your? Your background music, is that something?
Background music, we got a combination of Simon Shump, who's a composer and teacher. He helped compose certain elements of the background music as well. James Thorley, got to give a shout out to him for the amazing sound environment as far as the effects go.
Yeah.
Brandon Vix is really responsible for the background music overall, and generally the music throughout the game. He's an absolutely amazing composer. Highly recommend if you want to roam around SoundCloud and look up Brandon Vix. That's V-I-X.
V-I-X?
He is just an amazing, amazing musician. Like when it comes to sound, that's a guy. James Thorley, again, like for like making the sound environment happen and kind of bringing it all together in terms of the effects and stuff. James is a legend too. Like really, between all three of those guys, we've been very, very, and I mean like capital V, very fortunate to work with these guys.
Right.
They're like beyond our caliber. Like as an indie team, like we don't deserve them. They're amazing.
Dude, the game almost looks like it's ready for release. Just playing it, you know what I mean? Like it's. This is incredible, man. This is incredible.
The demo that everybody's gonna get leading into the Kickstarter. So
yeah. Hopefully. No, if you were to put this on, if I was to be a random that kind of just joined into the chat or whatever, I think that this game could come out like next week. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Oh, wrong way. Now the regeneration of your mana, would I imagine is what it is.
Yeah.
Where is that coming from? Once the game is fully fleshed, is that something that's gonna come back over time, or you'll have to? Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. So we definitely wanted to make it so that people weren't gonna be dry on magic, especially for such a heavily magic involved game.
Yeah.
So it will come back over time. Plus, you'll be able to acquire potions and, you know, orbs of magic and stuff like that that'll replenish your mana a little faster.
Okay. Yeah, because that makes sense though, because at first I was a little bit worried about, you know, what happens when you get to a puzzle that requires magic and you're now out of magic.
Yeah.
But if it self regenerates, then it makes sense. This is great, man. Fuck, I love. You know, the other thing I'm quite enjoying is there isn't many situations where I feel like I'm just pushing one button at a time. There's like constantly challenging button smashing happening. You know.
Right.
Like here, like, you know, I'm not just hopping around. I have to try to double jump. Fuck. Oh! There we go. Just needed to reset. Trying to bounce around like crazy. Tell us a little bit more about what you got going on as far as links with this. I know you have... a link tree going on with Sak'd.
That link tree is crammed full. So like we're on every social channel. Marketing has been pretty much a full-time job. Just trying to participate in things like Wishlist Wednesday and stuff like that on Twitter. Trying to mesh with other devs and trying to promote not just our project but their project too. And
right.
You know, just to kind of keep that family growing, one, because there's a lot of really, really talented, like, indies taking over.
Yeah.
So many of these AAA companies just aren't able to keep up with a lot of the story that these people are pumping out. Like, some of seriously amazing stuff. So we've been trying to, you know, flood all the social streams, Twitter and stuff like that.
Right.
Facebook. Instagram's been kind of lacking, but like I said, it's kind of a full-time job.
It is, yeah. It's definitely something that's very difficult to keep up with, and I'm kind of experiencing that right now, with my stream being so fresh and kind of just starting out. It's been very difficult to try to keep up with all that. I can't even imagine what it would be like for you guys.
Yeah, it's crazy. And what makes it worse is like every platform has a different format. Like,
yeah, that TikTok, doesn't help.
Instagram, Twitter. You know, there's certain protocols and certain etiquette that you've got to watch out for on each of those things.
Yeah, yeah.
And of course, making like really, really damn sure not to participate in the politics of the internet.
Yeah, it's very difficult to stay out of that, man.
Like, you know, somebody's asking like the other day, like. And actually, I've been asked that before too. Like, is Sak'd a boy or a girl? And I was like, well, Sak'd's whatever you want him to be.
Yeah. It's a Sak'd.
It's not too hard to put a penis on a pillow, but
yeah.
Sak'd's gonna be whatever you want it to be. Sak'd's a pillow.
Yeah, it's a pillow. Yeah. And people know they everything needs to be Yeah, let's not get there, because I feel like it's just not going to be helpful. We're just trying to avoid it. I'm about to go ahead and get into it. Yeah, but it's very hard not to, though, man, because you get drawn in. It's
Zach is a living Takemakura.
Now, tell me a little bit about your developing team. So you guys have this game on the go. Have you guys done anything else that guys could people could check out?
Andy's working on another game called Nekosuke. That's his passion project. I don't know, Andy, definitely post a link to that project in the chat if you get a chance. Like, Andy's really, like, amazing. Like, I don't mean to, like blow up your head over there, Andy, but, like, seriously, like, developer extraordinaire. He's juggling, you know, Sak'd as a project. He's got his own passion project, and he's, you know, trying to maintain, you know, a steady flow of work like the rest of us as well. So,
right.
But yeah, you know, the talent on the development side between him and X-Battle, yeah, really, really talented people. So, like, check out their projects for sure.
Yeah, no, for sure. And once you get the links going, I'll make sure to link them on our Discord and on my Instagram and all that as well.
And like we've had like Rosa, like Rich, who also contributed a lot to like the art, like, you know, the pillars, skulls, background elements and stuff that you see. A lot of that is Rich's handiwork.
Right.
His wife Rosa worked really hard on a lot of the environmental concept art. So like we went full bore with, like, you know, really working hard on the concepts, getting all that down before moving in. We didn't just jump into character creation. We didn't just jump into, like, you know, here's a character and, like, let's mash it out. We worked really hard on whether or not the characters, the shape of them, their characteristics were going to mesh with the environments that we were putting them in. You know, trying to really go that extra mile to make people feel that these characters really belonged in the places they were being encountered in.
Well, you guys so far have done a great job with it, man. And just based on what I can see, because even just looking at the two different worlds that you guys sent us in with the Egyptian or whatever and the desert one and the Aztec one,
it
does give you that different feel.
Oh, that's good. I'm gonna get called away for craft dinner in a moment here. So, yeah, I've also been like banging out this amazing and incredibly difficult, like, work schedule. So, like, normally I've been working like 2 a.m. get up at 2 a.m. and then start work right away and then work until about 7 or 8 o'clock.
That's insane, man.
6 o'clock, try and squeeze dinner in there, but it's been crazy trying to keep this project moving forward and juggling all of that at the same time. Like Andy can attest, and Grandius, like, everybody's working full-time jobs at the same time, still trying to, you know, cram 10, 20 hours into this game every week.
Wow. Man, and you know, and people like me complain because I got to work 3 days a week.
Yeah. I mean, we're really hinging on the success of the Kickstarter, and hopefully that'll give us an opportunity to take a break from the day jobs a bit.
Yeah,
and, you know, kind of peel those schedules back and work on Sak'd
full time. No, and I can't. I mean, just you telling us that you haven't been able to, you know, in a way, give it your 100% because you've had to obviously live the life of an adult. I can't imagine what you guys are going to be capable of doing when the Kickstarter kicks in, you know?
Yeah, if we get full-time hours, man, we'll just eat, sleep, and breathe this stuff.
No kidding. And I mean, just look at what you have achieved.
We'll be coming to life for the demo, so, you know.
Unreal, man. That was great.
He'll be on the scene.
This is great, man. Thank you so much for letting us play this.
Yeah,
thank you so much. Thanks, for yeah, man, of course.
All your audience too for sticking around through this.
Yeah, and, thank you guys.
Yeah, thanks Andy for coming in and being here with us as well. Yeah, thanks for having us here. I really appreciate it.
No, man. Again, like I said, I've been supporting you with this project since you first told me about it. In the minute that you kind of showed me what the idea of it was, I fucking fell in love with it right away. I thought it was cool and I thought it was neat and everything, and like I said before, I mostly wanted to support you as an individual, but I'm gonna tell you right now that
Princess Food's
ready. That now that gotcha. now that the now that the I play the game, I'm excited for both you and now Andy as well, and of course the game itself. I really hope that this gets out there soon. Before you go, I'm gonna get one of you guys to make sure we post or tell me where we can find more information about the game and all that stuff, and I can put that onto my socials.
Yeah, so that Linktree link has like absolutely everything.
Okay.
I don't know if I can post that right now in channel, but I'll try.
I can do it if it's something you can read out.
Yeah, I just don't know if the bot will let me.
Okay, let me try to turn that bot off real quick.
Yeah, the Linktree has absolutely everything. All of our social links, ways to contribute. You want to buy us a coffee, you can do so there. Go ahead, be the first. Also, just wanted to drop a note and say, hey, thanks, Danny, as well, and like WGT40. Some of your followers here, like, for participating in this and just being like interactive with the chat and stuff. It's great to have like additional people involved and great to see your comments and stuff. Like, we love feedback, we love critique, so you know, feel free to chime on, follow us on social media, find us there, and let us know what you think of what we're doing. Or if there's any way that you think we might be able to improve what we're doing, we love to listen.
Yeah, thank you guys. I on my behalf as well, as being the one doing the streaming, I appreciate the support of you guys being here. I know most of us are kind of local here, so it's awesome that we're kind of contributing in that aspect. I'm going to be posting that Linktree link on the social medias and stuff, and anything related to today's session. I'll also be making videos and whatnot, like highlights to it. Again, man, I can't thank you enough for letting me play this. Not only letting me play it, but also stream it. It meant a lot, and I can't tell you enough how much I enjoy that, man. Like, that was a blast. Hey,
first time stream. So.
Oh yeah, that was a full blown exclusive. Look at that.
Yeah, you were the first screen Sak'd live. First live appearance, really. Nice.
We did it. Fucking party, man. It up.
Yeah. Much love, Jose. Thank you so
much.
Yeah,
no, again. Thank you, brother. Thank you.
Hey, everyone. I'm Audi.
All right, brother. Take care, man.
Yeah, you too. Andy, have a good night. Danny, everybody, thanks again. We'll talk to you guys all soon.
See ya, brother.
Peace.
So what did you guys think? Because that was great, man. I truly did enjoy playing that a lot, man. Oh, no problem, Andy. Thank you for all the work that you put into this game. Obviously, especially with what Kelly's saying to us, you must have dedicated quite a bit of time behind it, man. And it really shows the passion that you guys are doing with this game. It seeps through the screen, to be honest. You can tell that it isn't one of those games that you just made for the sake of making a game. You can really tell that it's a game that you love, that you're doing it as a passion project. It was absolutely awesome, man. The controls, I played with I didn't use the keyboard, I used my controller, and I do have to say that the responsiveness of everything was great, which is ideal for a game where you need to be jumping and pushing multiple buttons at once. It felt so smooth. It's a game made with love, hope, and dreams. And like, again, you can tell, Andy, it's pretty evident. You can see it in the, not only the art, you can see it in the sound effects. You can really see it in the background and more than anything in the tiny details that you guys have put into it. To me, just the fact that you added the your development team's logo in the back of the coins, that's awesome. And the statue, the idea of one of us being able to have our statue in the background, it's great. So thank you guys so much. I'm very excited, man. I'm kind of speechless. I'm short for words here, because I've been, it's not, I don't want to, I'm very honest, and I'm not going to overhype something that I don't truly like. But I don't want to say that it was like a dream come true, but I've been looking forward to this moment for a while. Like I said, I met Kelly, I think it must have been about 3 years ago. For sure, over 2 years ago. And I get, like I said, anybody that I play D&D with, I've been like handing out pins and keychains and whatnot. And so I feel like I feel like I've been waiting for a lifetime to play this game. So it's exciting to finally get my hands on it. Let alone the fact that it was so beautiful. Let alone the fact that the music, everything went with it. The controllers were great. The gameplay was awesome. I can't wait for the rest of the world to get a chance to play the demo, because you guys got something really good going on here. And I'm excited to see this on the Switch, and to just show you guys when my kid is playing on his Switch, and because I can guarantee you he's gonna be all over this, man. I might actually let him play it next week, sitting on the computer, to see if he likes it, so I can give you guys some feedback from a 6-year-old, which I think he's gonna enjoy it a lot. It's right up his alley. But this was great, man. And I never thought in my lifetime that I would be doing a stream for a game, let alone a game that has not been out yet. So thank you, Kelly and Andy, for allowing this to happen, because obviously you must have had a saying in it as well. This was cool. This was cool, man. I could do this again. Once the demo's out, completely, fully out, I will for sure be streaming that as well. So thank you guys, all of you, for sticking around for as long as you did. Thank you for keeping us company. And just like Kelly said, the amount of feedback on everything was awesome. All the questions, everything was cool. I'm going to take a little bit of a break because I haven't eaten anything. And when I come back, I believe that Danny and I are going to continue our Rocket League adventures. I just got to double check with him. And if he's not down, I'll probably play some Papers, Please. But again, thank you guys so much for sticking around. I appreciate you all, and I will be right back.